Hey, Dr. Karen here. Welcome to another edition of the Spiritual Medicine Digest. And I got some pretty interesting information from Source. The other day I was doing some self-healing, and the crystalline DNA that we possess kind of popped up into my mind. And it's been a while since I spoke about the DNA. There are parts of our DNA which in the past they called junk DNA, which the spiritualists feel are very important parts of our DNA, part of our ascension. And then, of course, there's other parts of the DNA that we've already mapped and know what they do. And then the rest of it, they don't know what it's for. So they used to call it junk DNA. But there's a recalibration that's occurred so that our DNA is now in its crystalline form or functions as a crystalline. I think that's very interesting, like a crystalline antenna. So I got that we recalibrated our DNA to the crystalline form. So that was many, many months ago. And I just checked mine and it was like, yep, it's fully crystalline. So, okay. So I was asking Source, like, well, what do you want me to know about that? So I got that we need to understand how it's activated. Now, normally what happens is that a signal from the outside, like outside the cell, okay, say there's a hormone or say vitamin D or something like that, attaches to a receptor on the outside of the cell. The receptor changes its shape. And then because the shape changes, there are other molecules and enzymes and activations that occur inside the cell. They go into the nucleus and basically tells the DNA, hey, make this protein, okay? So we know from Bruce Lipton's work, Biology of Belief, that if we have negative beliefs, that causes the DNA to transcribe something different than if we have positive beliefs. So I think that's very interesting. Now, you've also probably heard that, you know, toxins in our environment are really bad for us. And the reason is that sometimes the toxins gum up this whole system. And then the DNA, you know, transcribes some other type of protein or peptide, or, you know, it's just not organized and it's not wonderful. So what Source was trying to tell me was that there was something that can, let's just say, override negative signals from our environment, whether it be a toxin or a negative emotion or whatever. And so I asked, what is it? You know, and it has to do with our crystalline DNA. And so what I got was the word attention. So where we attend, where our attention goes, that's what signals or activates our crystalline DNA to get to work. So let's think about, you know, what we're focusing our attention on. You know, so are we focusing our attention on what's right with the world or what's wrong with the world? Are we focusing attention on someone else, like everything that they need to do to make us happy or everything they need to do to make themselves better, whatever, and not focusing attention on ourselves? So anytime we see someone that, you know, is doing something that we don't want them to do, one of the greatest things you can do is look back at yourself and going, that's really interesting. How is it that this is bothering me? You know what I mean? And then focus the attention back on ourselves. So the other part of attention that's really interesting is that yesterday and today, I had a period of time, luckily not when I was skating, where I was proxying for dark matter. Now, this is different from when we talk about light and dark, as in, like, you know, good and evil, so to speak. But dark matter quantum physics is considered what we cannot see, that is not substance. Okay, so it's like the space between the substance. So that includes spiritual stuff. So it's interesting. So I thought, well, I'm proxying for dark matter. So, I mean, is there a problem with dark matter? Does it have a low light score? You know, no. That wasn't the issue. But what it did give me a hint was that we all are made of light and dark matter, you know, the yin and the yang, you know, we're made of light matter and dark matter. And however, we focus most of our attention on the light matter, meaning what we can see and feel and touch and logically deduce, you know, that kind of thing. Whereas dark matter, if our attention increases in our dark matter. That's part of our spiritual ascension and part of probably our magic, you know, being able to create out of nothing. So what was necessary for that is more attention to dark matter. So I asked, well, how do we attend to this, you know, the yin of the yin and the yang? And what I got was, you know, attention to nothing or space. So it is like the attention, for example, paying attention to the space between the words that I'm saying. So I know I'm talking pretty quickly, but if instead of, you know, I know you're processing what I'm saying, but if you try to pay attention to the spaces between the words that I'm saying, then you have an idea of that kind of attention. And Frank Kinslow in his Kinslow method talks about you stillness. That's pretty much the same thing. So if you've been practicing you stillness, then you know, are ahead of the game. So the ideal, I asked, is 30% of our waking attention in the space between things, or in stillness, or in dark matter. And I thought, wow, that's a lot. So I'm thinking, okay, so but why am I proxying for dark matter? So what it was is to help humanity help humanity be able to do that. So I did a healing on humanity, not dark matter, but humanity. So to help bolster humanity's ability and focus and attention on, you know, the space between things. And so after that, then I was no longer proxying. So today when I was proxying, I just had to reinforce the field that I created yesterday, and then I wasn't proxying anymore. So that was cool. Now, I had been asking, you know, like, can I have some other signal that I'm proxying besides my body kind of going wonky and not being like coordinated, especially right before adult nationals? So what happened yesterday is that I was working on downloading music on iTunes, and iTunes was super slow. And I thought, well, it can't be Mercury in retrograde. I checked that. It wasn't that. Because we made ourselves impermeable to or impervious to Mercury in retrograde. I don't know if you saw that video on the Light Warrior Support Group and Light Warrior Network, but if you haven't, I posted that so you can receive that healing to become impervious to the negative effects of Mercury in retrograde and other so-called, you know, stressful astrological events. So that wasn't it. And what it was that when I'm proxying for something else, my energy shifts and changes. And that nice little buffer that I had around myself to protect my electronic equipment, those of you that have taken my ET and Light Warrior course for entities and stuff like that know what I'm talking about. So, but when I'm proxying, I don't think that buffer is there. I'm somebody else, you know? So yeah, the electronics started going wonky. But as soon as I did that healing and got back to me, everything worked fine. You know, same thing today. I was trying to send a video and it wouldn't send. It was taking forever. And I was like, oh, wait, maybe that's my signal that I'm proxying. Sure enough, it was. So I caught it real early before I had any sort of physical symptoms. Yay for me. So we could do that correction. So I'm no longer proxying. So that was very, very quick. And I love that. So I thought, well, better the electronics not working and giving me a signal that there's something I need to do rather than my knee hurting or something like that, you know, when I'm proxying. So just in case you tend to proxy for others, maybe you can tell your guide team, hey, can you give me some other outside signal long before, you know, my body reacts to this? So that'll be easier to check in, to know, to test your brain balance. So just a little tip there, maybe that'll help you. So a couple of really cool things coming up on Monday. Now I'm actually going to be traveling to Adult National, so I'll be gone all week. Okay, so I may not answer your emails or your texts and things like that during the week. So that's my week off. So James and I are going Monday. And Cathy Homer, my wonderful friend, energy healer, amazing person, is going to be doing a healing show for you in my stead. So she's going to be logging into my radio show panel, and she is going to be talking about the importance of the frequency and colors of your food. Now, of course, you know she's an expert in nutritional energetics and recalibrating your multidimensional body. Those are her programs. And Kathy's always pushing the envelope, and that's what I love about her. And she was so kind to say yes when I asked if she could do the healing show for me. So she is going to be on the air 12 noon Eastern, talking about the color of food. And you are going to get a chance to raise your hand, and she can unmute you, or you can go in the chat and ask her some questions about healing issues that you have. And she's going to be doing healing ongoing during the whole show. It's amazing how she can do that. She can do this light waving stuff while she's talking. So if you want to receive some healing, complimentary, awesome healing from Kathy, definitely be on the show. And even if you're not on the show live and watch the replay, it still works just as well. So again, 12 noon Monday, that's April the 9th, I'll be traveling. Kathy is going to do the show for me. And the other thing I wanted to announce, which is really super, super exciting to me anyway, is that my Supercharge Your Healing Power program, that's going to be a live event in September 7th to the 9th, I've decided to offer what we call pre-event accelerator training. Now, this training's probably worth, you know, over $1,000. But you know me, I just love to give stuff away and I get so excited. So what the accelerator training is about is for people that are registered for the event, as the months go, we're going to be releasing, you know, in a series, these specific, very specific healing and training modules for you. And they're not going to be long, so don't worry about, you know, having to spend hours studying. But and what we're going to be doing, I can't tell you all of it yet because it's developing as we go. But what we're going to do is I'm offering every person, including your friends and family who also sign up, you know, for the actual program, we're offering you an actual abundance assessment. Now, you will have to do some homework for that, meaning that I need to know what, you know, your vision is. So we'll send you forms to fill out and stuff like that. And I'm going to do an abundance assessment on you and give you written feedback as to those 7 points. Like, where is it that you need to work on now, you know? So at least you know what your abundance assessment is for what you say you want to manifest. And then we're also going to check the divine alignment score too. And the third thing we're going to do is I'm going to check your TOLPAKAN healing power levels. So a power level of 10 is somebody who is just very practiced, you know, has done a lot of TOLPAKAN healing and done a lot of internal work and a lot of sensitives already, just when they get attuned, not even practicing TOLPAKAN healing, are already at like a 7.3, you know, that's like the average now. So what's really cool is we can check you before you come. Okay, this will be right before you come. We'll do that check. And then we can check you at the end of the program. Wouldn't that be cool? Yeah. So we're going to give, and right now until April 15th, we have the super early bird pricing. So that's like 80% off the original event price, which is $495. So now it's $97 until April 15th. And then once you register, you get the friends and family code as well. So if friends and family come, you can kind of gift them, you know, 50% off through this code, and they can register with you. Look out for your email if you've already registered in the first week of May for that first accelerator training. I am going to be traveling quite a bit in April. I'm going to be going to my mentor's live event at the end of April, and then of course Adult Nationals next week. So if you don't, if you want to register and you haven't yet, the website is KarenCann.com/supercharge, all one word. So KarenCann.com/supercharge. And then the last thing is that, you know, for the month of April, and this is going to happen the week between I'm traveling, the week of the 16th of April, I'm looking at my calendar here, that we're going to launch another module, TOLPAKAN Master Healing Class. And right now, the poll that we set up in the Light Warrior Support Group, the poll, what's winning is about weight. So if you know, you're not sure what poll I'm talking about, you can go to the Light Warrior Support Group and type in poll, P-O-L-L in capitals, in the search bar, and you could see that poll. Previously, it was like cold and flu symptoms, which I thought was a great idea to do with the change of season, but it seems like people want to work on weight and obesity. You know, I'm really good at assessing that stuff. I'm not really good necessarily at getting rid of my own extra fluid, although I'm getting better, especially after figuring out my Lemurian blueprints were like, you know, sabotaging me, but And now I have human blueprints, so that's really helping. But we'll see whatever topic you want to do. So if you haven't voted, go ahead and vote, or even just, you know, type it in, you know, in the discussion. Say, hey, for April's Light Warrior Revolution topic, I'd be interested in XYZ, and tag me so I you know, catch that post, okay? So that's going to be that week. And if you haven't joined us for the Light Warrior Revolution, what that is a monthly membership where every month we do a masterclass in TOLPAKAN healing. This is not appropriate for you if you're absolute beginner and don't really even know what TOLPAKAN healing is, because you know, you need to have some muscle testing. And if you've done any of my other programs already, then it's, you know, appropriate for you, because this is another level up. So more complexity to understand why things are happening in the body. And there's a lot of great questions you can ask of source that you might not have thought of asking, but because I'm a medical doctor, I get to ask all these detailed questions. So if you're into that, if you really love to learn, that is for you. And that website's karenkan.com/LWR. Stands for Light Warrior Revolution, LWR. Okay, guys, that's it for this week. And next week, we'll see whether in between skating, I get to do a spiritual medicine digest. So stay tuned and wish me luck. Lots of love to you guys. Have a wonderful week. Bye.